Nipsey Hussle was and still is a great person. Although he died on March 31st, his legacy still lives on through all the works he made and all the people he influenced, helped, and impacted. He once said the greatest human act is to inspire, and that's what he did. He hustled and motivated. He inspired people, taught people, and showed people that there is another way to make it besides gang banging, selling drugs, or running around the streets doing drugs. Other ways besides the usual rapping and playing sports too. He inspired people by being a role model and someone people could look up to and aspire to be. Someone that people could relate to. Someone else that came from a low-income community and that made something from the nothing they were handed at birth. That through hard work and dedication and never giving up, that through all the struggles and obstacles that life placed along the way, he jumped every hurdle and kept running the marathon till he got to where he wanted to be and still kept running, all while teaching people about business, investments, life, and giving back to the community he was born and raised in. He was walking, talking knowledge and positivity. And I could keep going on, but he has a lot of music and a lot of interviews and videos where you could get that knowledge and motivation from. Sadly, on March 31st, 2019, by Crenshaw and Slauson, Nipsey Hussle was shot 6 times and killed in front of his store. The suspect has now been caught and is in LAPD custody. He was apprehended as he was trying to check into a mental hospital. The suspect is identified as Eric Holder. As the news is still fresh in our mind and our heart, we try to think of a reason why this happened. There are a lot of theories going around about how the government did it, and that someone or something killed him or paid someone else to kill him, primarily because he was in the process of making a documentary about Dr. Sebi, a doctor that claimed to cure many things with mostly just herbs. He would not have been the first person to die under similar circumstances, and that's probably why it's the most popular. It is believed that Dr. Sebi himself was killed by the government for the things Dr. Sebi was advocating and promoting. Nipsey Hussle also once said in an interview that if something goes down because of the documentary, that people should riot. Now that the suspect in the murder has been caught, it's been going around that the reason for the murder was because of jealousy or envy and mostly anger. That the suspect had just gotten out of prison, and the word going around is that he had snitched and cooperated with police. Nipsey said that he didn't want any snitches around, and hearing that, the suspect probably hurt and angry left and came back, firing off 6 shots at Nipsey, with 5 hitting the body and 1 hitting the head. He also hit 2 other people with him, leaving them injured, and then leaving out the alley that he had came in through in a white car. There is camera footage of that happening, and that is the story police are going with. It is also being reported that the suspect's family was also hurt while police tried finding him. I don't know if it's true, but it could very well be possible because of how many people cared for Nipsey and where they were all looking for him, for the suspect, Eric Holder, and yeah, people were mad. The world lost a great person with a bright future over pretty much nothing. Nipsey had a meeting the next day with prominent figures to talk about how to lower gang violence and to help out the community more. He wasn't able to go to the meeting to discuss these topics, but I feel like his death made more people want to discuss the issues he was raising awareness in and continue his legacy through support of his music or his store, supporting the community, some people like Nick Cannon even wanting to continue the documentary Nipsey was working on. Nipsey also had a program where lower income kids could connect with Silicon Valley, bringing even more opportunities to people that needed and wanted some. Nipsey lit a flame inside the torch of many people's minds and hearts, and we can't let it burn out now, especially while there is still a marathon to finish. Nipsey's death also woke people up to the violence and bullshit going on in the streets and the world too. While Nipsey's death was talked about everywhere, as it should have, this situation reflects a bigger issue in lower income communities. Just this year, there have been 15 shootings in LA, and I'm sure many more other places. And while the number is going down, are we really doing everything we can to stop it? Why does it seem that like anytime anyone tries to change their life for the better, or is trying to do good, they die? Why are people so quick to start shooting anytime feelings get hurt or money is involved? Why is black on black, Hispanic on Hispanic, Asian on Asian, poor on poor, crime so rampant? Why are there so many wars and why does the world never seem to change? It seems like every year we're on the verge of a nuclear war that could destroy the world. The rich get richer and the poor get poorer. We're living in a crazy world that doesn't seem to make any sense. Donald Trump is president right after Obama. And if you try to look at the bigger picture, you could see what's going on. The obvious racism, corruption, nationalism, distractions, and evil. We live in a world where war is money and money is everything, and a lot of the few truly big corporations have privately owned prisons that make money off the prisoners' free or very cheap labor. And police are trying to reach a quota for a new car and work with the same criminals they are supposed to stop, while they work against the people they are supposed to protect. Schools aren't being funded as well as they should be, and teachers aren't appreciated. Neither are the hospitals, physical and mental. Jobs are being lost, which leave a population of uneducated, unhealthy, and poor people that don't have much to live for or even know anything more than the few things that they do have. Give them liquor, drugs, and guns. Make them hate themselves and each other while making them fall in love with money. And you have a crime farm, somewhere where you just moving the wrong way and you could end up in jail, in the hospital, or even dead. The perfect place for the police to meet quotas and arrest the public while protecting the criminals that set the place up to be like that in the first place, taking away fathers and mothers and brothers and sisters and ripping away families, a lot of people just trying to pay rent and survive. Arresting them for selling drugs the government gave a okay to bring inside the communities being destroyed. All while the pharmaceutical companies are selling the same thing to your kids and your parents, getting them addicted on Adderall or painkillers, meth or heroin, starting a cycle of hurt people hurting more people. Instead of a war on poverty, they have a war on drugs so the police can bother me. And not bother them. The rich get richer and the poor get poorer. The poor pay the taxes the rich people don't. And the rich separate the poor, divide them into groups of countries, states, streets, and colors. Divide them so they'll be easier to take on and conquer. And then spread fear and hate among all of them. Call them terrorists, gangsters, thugs. Let them take each other out. Till they're alone and lost, with no trust in the police or in other people. Make them hate themselves so the big corporations could sell the public a cure to the disease the big corporations made up and gave to the public. Now the public is addicted and killing themselves and their future, and their light is fading, but now it's being sparked up again by having a sense of community and pride and helping each other out. seeing through all the smoke and mirrors put in front of people, losing the love for their money and gaining more love for each other. More people trying to do good, not trying to let the negative thoughts and environment consume you enough to take a life so fast or ruin your own. Educating yourself and others, bettering yourself and the community around you, taking responsibility for your action. Every cause has an effect. And ignoring the lies we are told and remembering who we really are as kings and queens and gods of our own world. We have the power to shape the world just like Nipsey Hussle was shaping the world. It's our job to shape it as well.